Prosecutor Joe McGettigan in this case calling Jerry Sandusky's statement both last night and today in court ludicrous, among other terms. I'm joined now by Tom Klein, a Philadelphia attorney, also the attorney for victim number 5, who spoke in court this morning, very emotional today. Why was it important for him to speak?
Oh, my client was resolute in his determination to come to the court to have the judge and Mr. Sandusky hear him and hear the horrible impact that Mr. Sandusky had on his life.
You heard his radio statement last night. You heard him speak in court this morning. Once again, he brought money into this, as did Joe Amendola, saying that money is a great motivator. What do you say to that?
That it is preposterous, that it is offensive, and that it's just plain wrong. The thought that everyone is wrong but Mr. Sandusky, that there was a grand conspiracy starting with the victims, their parents, their families, the press, the prosecutors, Penn State, they've blamed everyone, even the media. And to think that all of these people conspired against him, including the court system and railroading him. That's still the mantra of not only Mr. Sandusky, who may not know better, but now of his attorneys on the courthouse steps. That's wrong. Justice has spoken here. A jury, when clear and convincing terms and with clear and convincing evidence, found Mr. Sandusky guilty. We have closed the book and turned the page. The appeal has no real prospect of any success.
And quickly, you found the sentence just?
The sentence was just. Mr. Sandusky spent 3 decades roaming the Penn State campus and Second Mile looking for victims and finding victims. Now he's finally where he belongs.
I'm Klein, attorney for Victim 5. Thanks for your time.
Thank you,
Let's send it back to Pat Shirocki in Philadelphia. Pat.
All right, Ben. Thank you very much.